We enjoyed playing. I think aside from what most people think about the differences in the guys and the personalities in the band, they genuinely are friends. I think sometimes it's hard to show that, but I think that's really an underlying thing that nobody has really tumbled to yet, you know. But I really think we are friends. We have our own ways of going about dealing with that friendship, you know, which may not be ordinary to most people, but there is a friendship there, and I think that bond was always there.
I would have said, let sleeping dogs lie, if I thought that this reunion were going to be lame. But it was anything but lame. It was good. If anything, we were a better band the summer of 83 than we were summer of 69, summer of 70. If anything, we were a much, much better band. And in most instances, that's not the case. And I thank whatever you want to call it, the force, God, Buddha, I thank whatever force is that's out there that allowed us to do this, you know, that even allows me to be sitting here talking about it. I mean, because it's been far more than special to me. It's been closer to magical for me. I had no idea it was the emotional highs that we would incur as a unit again. I had no idea that was in store for me.
Thank you. talking green smokies, been working on cars. Telephone ring, sing, ding-a-ling, talk about a thing. Not this morning. Don't wanna think about the night before, or maybe it's a bore behind an open door. Got no time for that this morning. If I had the mind or I had the time, maybe I could throw together a new kind of rhyme. Tell about my warning, but it's too late now. It's too late now. It's too late now. Think about a runaway dad that took away the only thing that I never had. Don't even miss him this morning. Don't wanna think about a cold goodbye or a high school buddy got a little too high. I can't help him out this morning. You was laughing me, so I'll go out to sea. And perhaps it's just as well, cause I'd rather be in hell. Be a wealthy man this morning, but it's too late now. It's too late now. It's too late now. Whatever happened to images, cause now they're gone. Worn out phrases just keep on hanging on. Whatever happened to homes as opposed to houses? Conversation sinks as the evening drowses, and it's just like 46201. Just like 46201. Whatever happened to early morning open skies? Faces half with melting eyes, yeah. Not for riddles that just play with time. Cause I'm still here and I can't beg a dime. I'm back here in 46201. Back here in 46201. There's something better waiting for me around the corner now. Small changes made. Oh, 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 oh. Come on and listen to my telephone ring. Sing, ding-a-ling, I talk about a thing. No, no, no. Just leave me alone this morning. Look out!
A song that was written by one of the finest composers in pop music in the world. His name is Randy Bachman. It's from, believe it or not, yes, this is from 1969 AD. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Not enough truth. Too
across the sun. She's come undone. Another new song for you now. This is written by our bass player, Mr. Jim Cale. And this is Jim's song. This is called Sunday Down.
Describe. Mother, Nature.
future. This is a song about a guy who used to be on the radio and television all the time, and he was a very strange character. This is one of those songs that brings back a lot of stories from the road, you know? Are you ready, boys? One, two, three! She said no, no, no. Romance ain't keeping me alive. I said, hey babe, do you want a coo-coo-coo? She said, ah. So I was left out in the cold. I said, you're what I've been living for. She said, I don't want to know.
She was digging the cat on the radio.
Clap for the wolf man. Rate your record high.
Yes, baby, now you're Dr. Love.
Clap for the wolf man.
You go digging till the day you die. Everybody talk about the wolf man's competence of love.
75 or 80 miles an hour. So I'm slow, slow, slow. Baby, I could stop right on a dime. Snuggle in, so baby, just my kiss. She said, not, not. I was out to bide my time. I said, hey babe, do you want a coo-coo-coo? She said, said, I'm about to overload. I said, you're what I've been living for. She said, I don't want to know.
You thought she was digging you, but she was digging me.
Clap for the wolf man.
He gonna
rate your record high.
As long as you got the courage, baby, I got the angle.
Clap for the wolf man.
You go digging till the day you die.
It's all according to how your boogaloo situation stands. You understand?
Clap for the wolf man.
You go
rate your record high.
Oh, yes, gracious.
Clap for the wolf man.
You go digging till the day you die.
You might wanna try, but I gon' keep 'em.
Clap for the wolf man. Clap for the wolf man. Clap for the wolf man. Clap for the wolf man.
Yeah, yeah.
Clap for the wolf man. Clap for the wolf man.
Yeah, yeah.
Clap for the wolf man. Clap for the wolf man.
Yeah, yeah.
Clap for the wolf man. Clap for the wolf man.
My man.
Clap for the wolf man.
Yeah, yeah.
Clap for the wolf man.
My man.
Clap for the wolf man. Clap for the wolf man. Clap for the wolf man.
I should laugh, but I cry, because your love has passed me by. You took me by surprise, didn't realize that I was waiting. Time goes slowly, but carries on, and now the best years have come and gone. You took me by surprise, I didn't realize that you were laughing, laughing, 'cause you did it to me, laughing the way it should be. Took away everything I had, you put the hood on me. To me, laughing, ain't the way it should be. Took away everything I had, you put the hurt on me. I go alone now, calling your name, after losing at the game. You took me by surprise, didn't realize that you were laughing. Time goes slowly, but carries on, and now the best years, the best years have come and gone. You took me by surprise, I didn't realize that you were laughing, laughing, 'cause you gave it to me.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. You say burrito, 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 burrito. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yeah.
Started, darling. Can't stop. And on and on and on. watushi, watushi. Yeah, 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 watushi. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 get up, yeah, 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 yeah. Like I come through the window like my ears, you know, like yeah, 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 yeah. Watushi, watushi. Come on and dance. Come on and dance. Watushi, watushi, yeah, 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 yeah. Come on and dance. Like ubli awa wa 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 wa. Come on and dance. Yeah, 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 yeah. Come on and dance. Come on and dance. Kick it, kick it. Come on and dance. Yeah, 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 yeah. Ooh, yeah. Come on and dance.
Are you having a good time? Because we're having a great time up here.
Anybody here see the noise, see the fear? want to do what the people do. To Paris, if you ever miss a plane, nothing much to do but sit around. Drink a little yawn, a cup of laughing, where you come. Have another glass of Paris Brown. I'm unknown and they're still driving. Write a song and leave the young girls crying. Planes are going up, planes are coming down. Bells around here about enough to drive a full boy mad. She's the robot, daddy, but bye-bye, yeah. Well, the mission was accomplished on the day that you arrived. Maria hung you out to let you drive. I'm unknown and they're still driving. By the song I need the young girls grooving. Planes are going up, planes are coming down. Bells around here about enough to drive a full boy man. Planes are going up, planes are coming down. Got to get the roaming and we're looking for a sister of my dad.
Hang on to your life.
This is called What's Gonna Happen to the Kids. Biotic brain, computer logic, acid rain, programmed emotion, mechanical love, polluted ocean, gosh, shout the boat.
What's gonna happen to the kids? 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 They'll be alright.
Heavy metal, dream machine, power techno, got a sonic beam, wicked defense, weapons race, Agent Orange, so much waste.
What's gonna happen to the kids? What's gonna happen to the kids? What's gonna happen to the kids tonight? What's gonna happen to the kids? They'll be alright. What's gonna happen to the kids? What's gonna happen to the kids? What's gonna happen to the kids? They'll be alright. What's gonna happen to the kids? What's gonna happen to the kids tonight? What's gonna happen to the kids? They'll be alright. They'll be alright. They'll be alright. They'll be alright. They'll be alright.
There is a certain, I've talked about the dream and living the dream. There is a certain inherent fast lane thing that comes with living that dream. Everybody wants you. Decisions have to be made against other things you normally would have done. Like, let's go and play for that guy. He was a great guy and he gave us a break. Or should we go to London and play for X thousands of dollars? Or should we play this club because we owe this guy a favor? Or should we go and play the Seattle or Woodstock Pop Festival? It's just another plateau of decisions. It's more money. It's more agents and managers hitting on you. Another record label saying, when is your contract here done? We want to sign you when it's done. And there's a whole lot of pressures. And ours were magnified because from these eyes, our follow-up record, Laughing, after that had sold about 800,000 copies, some DJ down south flipped it over and played Undone, and that song sold like, and then a million, 1.6 million copies, which in those days, the late 60s, was a lot of records. Right after that, No Time, an American Woman, in a space of, I think, 2 or 2.5 years, we had 4 or 5 songs that were classed as million sellers that made the charts. The pressures became astronomical. We really couldn't cope with the pressures.
I used to have a little contest with myself every day. I would finally get up in the air in the plane, and the contest was to figure out where I was going and where I had just been without looking at my itinerary, because I didn't know. I was that fried. Just didn't know. And now that I'm breathing sober air, I'm really lucky that it happened when I was that young and able to like sustain a lot of abuse, because like I've been doing a lot of work in the last couple of years, a lot of work, and I think back and I think I don't know how I survived that, because I know how I feel now with this maintaining a horrendous schedule. I don't know how I dealt with that at all. I don't know how I got through it. It was astounding.
Woo! When I left the Guess Who, it was the drug era. It was the late 60s, the psychedelic era. Myself being allergic to smoke, I never got into any drugs. I've never done a drug in my life. I find it hard to take an aspirin. The rest of the band, like anybody else around, was trying things out. So there was a real rift between us. When I left the band, many people said it in, I don't know if it was said in the band, but reviewers and people doing articles on the band said I could never make it in this business being straight. And I was determined to go out there and make it. And I was lucky enough to get Fred Turner, who's a real straight guy, and my brothers, and started the Backman Turner Overdrive. And in about 74, 75, we hit number one, album and single. I had made it, being straight.
There is a lot of autobiographical material in my own songs, because I was hurt tremendously by one woman in particular. You carry those scars for a long time. But an accountant doesn't have the release that an artist has. If an accountant's wife leaves him after 10 years of what he thinks to be a good marriage, what's he going to do? Go to work the next day and do the books better? You know, he can't pour that misappropriated emotion into doing someone else's ledgers any better. Whereas an artist has the luxury of pouring some of that emotion and getting some of that weight off his shoulders by sharing that hurt with other people who've had similar experiences.
these arms, long to hold you again. The hurting's on me, yeah, and I will never be free. Now my baby, no, no, you gave the promise to me.
It's almost been as though we were able to cheat time. We've been giving good parts in a Rod Serling episode, in a time machine, Twilight Zone, H.G. Wells kind of thing, where you can... It's almost as though 5 minutes has only lapsed. It's amazing. The first day of rehearsal, we must have learned almost 30 songs. The very first day of rehearsal, I had no idea. We would take a short break and we would start telling jokes from 1966 and 67. We would start calling each other by the old nicknames. What it has meant to me is that I have three great friends that would go to the end of the world for me if they knew I needed them. If they knew I was hurting, they would come and hug me and help me stop crying. It has taught me one of the truest meanings of friendship, professional friendship. It's easy enough to always stay close to a guy that you grew up next door to. Well, even that's not so easy sometimes, but if you can magnify that 5,000,000%, to have friends that are friends with a capital F and still be professional playing partners, there's no amount of money in the world that could buy that. It has taught me that I have three friends that I will never lose, and it has explained to me part of the magic that happened at the beginning, is that there is some chemistry there. It's almost, and I don't mean it to sound religious or fatalistic or whatever, but it's almost as though we had no choice. I don't mean the reunion per se, I just mean it's almost as though the parts were written before we were born.
It says to me that we did something that was valid, something that mattered not only to us but to a lot of people. It says to me that my own interpretations of situations, usually music or revolving around music, both individually and as a group, were accurate. That what we did was a fact, was valid. It had worth. We were on the money. We weren't kidding ourselves.
I don't know. It's almost like the old days. It's almost everything has happened so fast that I don't think I'm going to get a chance to reflect upon it until it's finished at a point, you know, till the concerts and the video and whatever we're doing is all finished, because it's almost like the old days. We just kind of slipped back into the way we operate and off we went on the old train again, you know. It's been great. The reaction and the emotional surge has been tremendous. There have been all kinds of emotions, all kinds of stimulation, you know, and it's really great. The audiences have been fabulous, better than I would have hoped. I thought they would be good, but I didn't think they would have the emotion that I've seen. I mean, it's been incredible.
For me, it was an opportunity that I could not pass up. I gave so much of my life to the Guess Who as I was growing up. When I left in 1970, I missed a lot of the rewards as far as acclamation and financial. To be able to go back now and do it all again before I'm 40, which is not too far away. And also Jim Cale, the same thing, we're both pushing 40. To be able to go back and cheat time. We call this our Rod Serling trip, our Twilight Zone tour of Canada. We're cheating time. We're slicing 10 years out of our lives. And going back, I feel like I'm 25 again when I'm on stage. It's something that not many people can do. A lot of athletes would like to do that, be pushing 40 and go back and play a football game with the rest of the guys who are in their 20s and go out there and really kick butt and really, you know, really do it. We're really doing it, and it feels great. We're out on stage, boy. I look around, and I see Jim and Gary and Burton, and it's very hard not to laugh out loud. To just, with happiness, just blurt out and laugh and say, this is phenomenal. The feelings there, being there, and having the people react to every song we play. Even some of the new songs now sound like the old Guess Who songs. We've been able to take new songs written last month or last year and put our feelings and our identity into it, and it still sounds like... sounds like the Guess Who.
by a matter.